Good morning, children. How are you all? In the last class, we read the story titled Rekha's New Friend. I hope that you all are thorough with the story. Today, we shall go through the questions and answers in the chapter. Are you ready? Then please open your textbook. Children, please take page number 8. Read and answer. So, let's read out the questions and find out their answers. First one, complete these sentences. So, a few sentences are given here. We need to fill in the blanks or we need to complete these sentences. Are you ready? Okay, then first sentence. The class was excited because... Why was the class excited? Because it was their first day in class 3. The class was excited because it was their first day in class 3. Rekha was sad because her best friend Manu had left the school. Why was Rekha sad? Rekha was sad because her best friend Manu had left the school. Then third sentence. The new girl Alice had come from. Where did Alice come from? Alice had come from Bangkok. Children, where is Bangkok? Bangkok is the capital of Thailand. The new girl Alice had come from Bangkok. The teacher asked Rekha to dash. What did the teacher ask Rekha? The teacher asked Rekha to introduce Alice to everyone. The teacher asked Rekha to introduce Alice to everyone. Fifth sentence. Alice enjoyed dash. What did Alice enjoy in the school? Alice enjoyed the music and dance classes. Alice enjoyed the music and dance classes. Children, just keep in mind that when you end a sentence, you should definitely put a full stop or period. The sentence should end with a full stop or period. Okay. So Alice enjoyed music and dance classes. Is the session clear to you? Is it clear? Okay, then let's move on to the next session. Answer these questions. Children, let's try to find out the answers for these 6 questions. First question, what was the class teacher's name? What was the class teacher's name? The class teacher's name was Miss Anita Tavon. Who was Rekha's new friend? Who was Rekha's new friend? Rekha's new friend was Alice. Why was Alice worried? Alice was worried that she did not have any friends. Why was Alice worried? Alice was worried that she did not have any friends. What did Alice like about the school? Alice liked the school as it was big. She also enjoyed the music and dance classes in the school. What did Alice like about the school? Alice liked the school as it was big. She enjoyed the music and dance classes in the school. What had Rekha brought for lunch? Rekha had brought idlis for lunch. What had Rekha brought for lunch? Rekha had brought idlis for lunch. What had Alice brought for lunch? Alice had brought pasta and fruit for lunch. Alice had brought pasta and fruit for lunch. Children, is it clear? Are these six questions and their answers clear to you? Well, then let's move on to the next session. C. Number these sentences in the correct order. A few sentences are given below. We need to number these sentences in their correct order, their correct sequence of events, the correct order. Okay, let's read the sentences one by one. A new girl joined their class. She was missing her friend Manu. Miss Tawang asked Rekha to introduce Alice to everyone. Everyone was excited to be in class 3. Rekha was feeling sad. Children, what happened first in the story? In these sentences, which comes first? In the beginning of the story, we see everyone was excited to be in class 3. Is it not? Everyone was excited to be in class 3. This comes first. So we can number it as 1. Then what happened? Everyone was excited to be in class 3. But one girl alone. Who is it? Rekha. Rekha was feeling sad. So we can number it as 2. Rekha was feeling sad. Why was she sad? Rekha was feeling sad because she was missing her friend Manu. So we can number it as 3. Rekha was feeling sad because she was missing her friend Manu. Then what happened? A new girl joined their class. A new girl joined their class. What was the girl's name? She was none other than Alice. Miss Tawang asked Rekha to introduce Alice to everyone. So lastly, Miss Tawang asked Rekha to introduce Alice to everyone. Children, did you make it right? Did you number the sentences in the correct order? So the number goes like this. 4, 3, 5, 1, 2. Okay? Clear? Okay, then let's move on to the next question. Discuss in class. Come on, let's discuss in class. We can discuss 3 questions. First question, do you think it is important to have friends? Why? Children, do you think that it is important to have friends? Do you all have friends? And why is it important to have friends? You may have varied responses for this. You may have different answers for this question. Some of you may be of the opinion that it's not that important to have friends. And some of you will agree to this statement that it is important to have friends. Anyway, let me tell you my answer. You can write your answer, okay? My answer is, yes, it is important to have friends. We play, study, eat, and share our things with them. Yes, it is important to have friends. We play, study, eat, and share our things with them. Then second question, what do you think is the best way to make friends? What is the best way to make friends? How can we make friends? The best way to make friends is to listen to them and share our things with them. Children, one of the best ways to make friends is to listen to them. We need to listen to our classmates. We need to listen to them and share our things with them. We should also share our things. Things such as food, sharpener, eraser, pencil, pen, books. Okay? So, what do you think is the best way to make friends? In my opinion, the best way to make friends is to listen to them and share our things with them. You can write your own opinion, okay? What do you enjoy doing with your friends? I enjoy playing, eating, studying, and sharing a lot of things with my friends. So, you can write your own answer for this question as well. What do you enjoy doing with your friends? My answer is that I enjoy playing, eating, studying, and sharing a lot of things with my friends. So, can we wind up this section? Are all these questions and answers clear to you? Okay, then let's move on to the next page. Page number 9. Replace the underlined words with their opposites from the box. Here we can see a box in which some words are given. Below we can see a small paragraph in which certain words are underlined. You can see some underlined words in this paragraph. And what we have to do? From this box, we need to pick up the words which are opposite in meaning to these underlined words. We need to find the words which are opposite in meaning to these underlined words, and we need to replace these underlined words with the words which are opposite in meaning to these words. Okay, we need to pick it from this box. So first of all, let's read the passage. Rekha looked at the old red bicycle at her door. It was a dull, cloudy day. It was a dull. Dull means uninteresting, lacking brightness, boring. Okay, it was a dull, lacking brightness. It was a dull, cloudy day. Cloudy means covered with clouds. And she was looking forward to a short ride with Alice. Rekha was looking forward to a short ride. Short means small. Okay, small. Small ride with Alice. The children set off. The children started off their journey. Set off means started their journey. The road was rough. The road that they traveled through was rough. Rough means uneven or irregular. The surface of the road was uneven or irregular. It was stony or rocky. Okay. And they rode sadly. Alice and Rekha rode sadly. Sadly means unhappily, sorrowfully. A warm breeze blew as they rode uphill. A warm breeze. What do you mean by warm? Warm means hot. A warm breeze. Breeze means? What do you mean by breeze? Light wind. Okay? Breeze means light wind. A warm breeze blew as, blew is the past tense of blow. Blew as they rode. Rode is the past tense of ride. A hot light wind blew as they rode uphill. Uphill means towards the hill. As they rode towards the hill or towards the slough. In the distance, black cows were grazing in small fields. So, in the distance, they saw black cows. And what were the cows doing? The cows were grazing. Grazing means eating grass. The cows were eating grass in small fields. So, this is a passage. Opposite words are also known as antonyms. Antonyms. Antonym means a word opposite in meaning to another word. These are some of the words given in the passage. From the box given below, we need to choose the word which is opposite in meaning to these words. Okay, let's start. First word, old. What's the antonym of old? And old opposite? New. dull. Dull opposite bright. Cloudy. Cloudy opposite sunny. Sunny. Short opposite long. Rough opposite smooth. Okay. Old opposite new. Dull opposite bright. Cloudy opposite sunny. Short opposite long. Rough opposite smooth. Clear? Next. Sadly opposite happily. Sadly opposite happily. Warm opposite cool. Uphill opposite downhill. Downhill. Black opposite white. Small opposite large. Clear? Now let's read this paragraph by replacing the underlined words with their opposites from the box. Rekha looked at the new red bicycle at her door. It was a bright sunny day and she was looking forward to a long ride with Alice. The children set off. The road was smooth and they rode happily. A cool breeze blew as they rode downhill. In the distance, white cows were grazing in large fields. Clear? Find 7 words related to school in this word search. Here we can see a box, and in this box, 7 words are hidden. 7 words related to school are hidden in this box. We can see one word here, student. Similarly, there are 6 more words in this box. We need to find out those words. It's a very interesting activity, isn't it? Can you do it alone? Children, then please do it. Spell right. Spell means say or write the letters of a word in the correct order. Okay? Spell means form words in a particular order or to say or write the letters of a word in the correct order. When we add E to some words, their sounds change. Read these words aloud. Can, cane. When E is added, can became cane. Bit, bite. Hop, hop. Cut, cute. See, when E is added to these words, the word changed. Can, cane. Bit, bite. Hop, hop, cut, cute. Add an E at the end of each of these words. Read them aloud. When we add E to some of the words, the meaning of the word and their pronunciation changes. At, when we add E, 8, it becomes 8. At, 8. Ton, torn. Mad, made. Pin, pine. Hat, hate. Hug, huge. Not, not. Cup, cube. Din, dine. Tap, tape. Tap, tube. Kit, kite. See, how the word and its pronunciation change when we added e to these words. It's very interesting, isn't it? Children, did you like today's class? All the activities were very simple and interesting, weren't they? I hope you all enjoyed the class. Thank you for your patient listening. Let's meet in the evening. Thank you and have a nice day.